3, 2, 1, blast off. It's that time of year again, and what a better way to celebrate the beginning of basketball season than a space-themed Magnus. That's right, Magnus has gone galactic, and it seems as though Ryder is its own galaxy this year. Students await outside eagerly to go into the gymnasium where Magnus will begin. I'm sure it will be an insane turnout, and I'm sure, like always, Midnight Magnus will be a great success. Pre-Magnus, what you see before me. They have everything to suit any creature's needs, from glow-in-the-dark face painting, to a flight simulator, to laser tag. I mean, what more could you want? They even have space-themed food, and they're showing the hit movie Space Jam. This is really a good way to kick off Magnus.
A few other pre-Magnus entities included a wrecking ball blow-up game, a moon bounce, and an appearance from Darth Vader, and even custom photos for anyone who wanted one. And here's another up-close look at the buffet of space-themed food.
So how are you enjoying pre-Magnus? What's your favorite part?
The food and the carnival stuff. It's awesome, baby!
I'm with Mike O'Brien. He's part of the SEC, the crew, helping to put all of this together. Mike, how are you enjoying pre-Magnus?
I'm really enjoying it. I mean, being part of SEC has been like something I really wanted to do since I came here, and helping out with Magnus, I mean, the atmosphere in here is just amazing.
Okay, and Mike, what is your favorite part of pre-Magnus?
I mean, I'm holding my hand at Dippin' Dots because I haven't had this in a long time, so I really wanted to try this.
All right, thanks a lot, Mike.
Magnus starts at 10:30 in the Alumni Gymnasium. This is when we get to see the cheerleaders and dance team perform. Here, a very exciting introduction of the men's and women's basketball teams and everyone's favorite, the slam dunk contest.
Just a little history on Midnight Magnus. It didn't get its official name until the 1990s.
And now we have a dance team, a cheerleading squad, and a DJ ready to provide top quality entertainment for Ryder students, but at least aliens for tonight.
Not to mention the three-point shootout and the highlight reel.
So get ready, Magnus is coming your way just in a few minutes.
It took maybe around 20 minutes for the hundreds of fans to pour into the alumni gym, and boy, were they ready to celebrate Magnus. The DJ knew exactly what the students wanted to hear, and he also knew how to get them amped for what was coming up next. The space rock bronc, the cheerleaders, the men and women's introductions, the dunk contest, and the dance team. The space bronc was probably one of the most unique parts of Magnus. We had our Ryder bronc dressed in a spacesuit as he walked slowly over to the moon rock in the center of the gym. The bronc then proceeded to stick Ryder's flag into the moon rock, which was the cue to get the cheerleaders and the basketball introductions started. Every year, the cheerleaders put on a phenomenal display for all the Magnus fans to enjoy. They make their showcase look worthy enough to use for any professional sport. And hell, they make the sport of cheerleading look out of this world. The time and effort the cheerleaders put into this one routine might even make us question their humanity. Because honestly, only superhumans can put on a performance like this. Once the cheerleading squad was done their fantastic routine, it was time for the basketball introductions. The women's team went first, graciously giving out t-shirts and showing just a little bit of flash. Then it was time for the men's team, and oh, what a show they gave the crowd. They gave out t-shirts just like the women's team. They were flashy as flash can be. The Magnus crowd went wild for both the men and the women, and I'm sure both basketball teams felt just as pumped up for their season as the crowd felt for Magnus. The dunk contest was great as always. There were regular style dunks that we've seen before, but still looked amazing. And then there were original style dunks that had the crowd on their feet cheering with delight. Contest was over, it was time for the incredible dance team. They made sure to keep the Magnus theme going while moving to the beat of originality. They were the last form of entertainment for Magnus, but it definitely didn't seem that way. The crowd unquestionably had that dance routine stuck in their heads on the way out, due to how exciting it was. This was no doubt the best way to end this year's Galactic Midnight Magnus.
This is Ashley Monahan with the news at Rider just after Midnight Magnus. I'm here with Coach Dempsey of the men's basketball team. Coach, how do you think Magnus went this year?
It was awesome. I mean, we've been doing it a long time, and this was probably one of the better ones. I think there was 300 or 400 people that didn't get in. I thought the dunk contest was exciting. The cheer team's awesome. The dance team was great. So it was really a good night, an exciting way to get the season started.
Yeah, I definitely agree. And what about the theme? Do you think that was a good theme? Do you think it related to anything with society, or you think it was just a cool theme for Magnus?
I thought it was cool. You know, I mean, they always do a good job coming up with something. It probably gets challenging because they have to change it every year, but I thought it was pretty cool.
What are your expectations for the upcoming season?
The expectations are high. I think we've built a really strong program. We have the foundation is there, the talent is there. Kids get along really well this year, so I think we'll have good chemistry. So we expect to be one of the better teams in the league and hopefully to be the team representing the MAC in the NCAA tournament at the end of the year.
Yeah, absolutely. Don't we all?
Yeah.
And are there any players that you have high hopes for this season?
You know, this is really more of a real team effort. I don't know that we'll have a star, but our seniors are the key. Novar and Brandon and Jeff are giving us good leadership. They're very talented. If those three collectively have a good year, I think everything will fall into place.
I'm here with Karen Torsha, Associate Director of Athletics and Coordinator of Midnight Magnus 2011. So Karen, Midnight Magnus was a huge success. What do you think?
I'm really impressed with all the different groups that came together between ACS, SEC, SGA, Campus Life, the Emerging Leaders. Did such a great job putting it on. And then the student body was just terrific tonight. I'm really excited about the atmosphere that we created planning it, but the atmosphere that the students brought. So I'm very thrilled.
Absolutely. And Midnight Magnus is always about the students. And along those lines, the theme of outer space. You know, how long did it take you to decide on outer space among all the other themes you were deciding on?
We started in April and we kind of narrowed it down. We talked to last year's Emerging Leaders group and basically that's what we do. They plan this one and then we let them decide the theme for next year. So in April we had about 3 or 4 themes and we really cut it down to over the summer we decided on the galactic theme and we started planning from there. So we've been planning this since about April and really heavily since about June, July.
There's so much stuff going on. Like you said, you started playing in April, and I bet everything was a huge show tonight. What was the stress level going into tonight from a couple months ago or even a couple weeks ago?
You know, we were actually so well prepared that this was probably the first time in the 12 years I've been here that I didn't feel any stress at all. Unbelievably, we had everything set, everything was ready. Normally at the last minute, we're adjusting the lighting or the sound or something is going on right as the doors are opening. Tonight, we were ready to go and open the doors at 6:30. So very pleased. I think that was because of the extra length and the planning that we did.
And last question. This year's theme was Galactic. Do you have any plans for next year's theme? Maybe a little hint that you want to give away?
No, I can't give away our hints. We do have about 3 or 4 ideas that we're throwing around right now, but you got to wait till next year and find out.
We really appreciate this. I enjoyed it. All of us here enjoyed it. You did a great job. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.